Hello viewers, I'm SP and welcome back to Let's Play Civilization 6, where I accidentally click on leader portraits all the time while trying to give the program focus again. So, this is what diplomacy looks like. Everybody doesn't like me. Only some people hate me. Nobody has strong enough feelings about to go to war, which is, I think, pretty good for us. It would be a news. I think our technological advantage is such that we'd be very likely to win any war we get into. But I do think that it would slow us down. Maybe not even in terms of turns, but just in terms of me having to devote a bunch of attention to things. The turns would take longer. There would probably not be any more turns. Also, I have no idea why the game was so jerky there during the scroll. It certainly shouldn't be. But we'll see if it clears up on its own. We can only hope. Alright, so we have a lot of focus on the capital right now. We're making a secondary spaceport in Kongo to help us produce spaceship bits.
You and I come by road
in parallel.
Rail, but economists travel on infrastructure. The effect of the mass media is not to elicit belief, but to maintain the apparatus of addiction.
So Cristo Redentor, which increases tourism from stuff, we're gonna ignore that for now. Broadway's not terrible. A free random boost is kind of neat, and that's a lot of points toward the culture victory. I guess we're gonna be ignoring that too. Honestly, we don't have very much use for the civics, except insofar as they are guiding us toward plus 30% production. Or 10% plus 1% for every 20 speeds. Why did I think this was 30? Anyway, plus 10% production, totally fine. Okay, so let us... Oh, we need to use our anti-tank crew for the first time. Man, I really like the animations. The artist did some great, great work on this game. Yeah, you were just gonna stay put until... Oh wait, what was your deal? Must occupy a district or wonder with a free... Okay, so do we have any place to put a portrait great work? These all take writing. We can put it in the palace. We have tons of room in the palace. We ran out of room in this bank. Yeah, alright. Back to the palace with you. This guy finished fighting that barbarian. I guess just go home. Okay, so... Our military academies and seaports generate science is like... There's so little... red stuff that would be at all applicable to anything we're doing. I'm just gonna... This increases our income slightly. I appreciate the updating graphics for everything. What I do not appreciate is that it really does feel like we're just, it does feel like we're just mashing end turn a lot. China and Aztec. We definitely don't have anything Aztec. So that is a medieval Aztec artifact. We don't have anything medieval yet. Well, what a bummer. Are we having amenity problems in Aquila? Oh, yeah. Sure. Okay. My archaeologist can do something else. There's lots of stuff to do. Is there an antiquity site over here? Sort of desecrate everybody's lands equally. Alright, so there's one by London. That's awfully far away, though. Keep running those production trade routes. I do feel like I have learned a tremendous amount about what to value as far as stats go, and also about how to build good cities. This one's not in anybody's territory. Go get that one. I wonder if he's going to be mad that I didn't actually move the archaeologist out. I think he probably won't get mad unless we actually do excavate another thing in his territory soon. So, if we hit the Science Victory tab, you can see here we've very nearly completed this. We just need to launch the Earth satellite, which we will do in 3 turns. For this, we have to launch the moon landing. We've already researched the thing. We just need to actually build it. And then we apparently have a lot of work left to do here. There's three parts, each of which has to be researched and built. We've got one of them researched. But the moment we get this done, we have 4 more things to build after this.
The whole palace complex is built along the central axis, the axis of the world. Everything in the 4 directions suspend from this central point, represented by these palaces.
Well, that kind of sounds like nonsense to me.
Since we were kids, when you boil it down, it's still a gas combustion engine.
Right, so we've got our Forbidden City. I don't need to. That guy is sleeping, as he must. This barbarian is doing a really good job of evading me. Okay, so we gained a wild card slot from the Forbidden City, which is awesome. Is there not a scroll? Okay, there is a scroll bar. I looked right past it. Okay, so do we want to jam just another economic policy in here? Probably, right? Plus amenities. We do have some amenity problems. We could get more gold, but I don't think we need it. Yeah, let's do that. So what exactly is our amenity status right now? Sorry, this is what I want. We have a housing problem in Kongo, and everybody's content or happy now. So that +1 amenity was apparently enough, mostly. Only 35 turns to build a spaceport. I honestly don't know what to do. So we have 0 amenities here. I guess we build an entertainment complex? I don't know that we really need one, but we also don't really have a lot else of value to do, right? Yeah, none of this stuff actually helps us. Trade routes from the city get +2 gold for every bonus resource in this city's territory. Yeah, we're not running any trade routes out of this city anyway. We can build spies. All of the projects produce stuff that's not super relevant. We're bottlenecked on production more than on science. There's no sense in really focusing on speeding up our science. I guess let's get another spy. We'll play around with the spy system a little bit more. Remember, we want to win this game. Of course we want to win this game. We always want to win. But what we're really here to do is learn more so that we can play better next time. And so we're kind of making all of our decisions to that end. Let's just see what stuff does. Russia found some mummies. With an archaeologist. Okay, so they're competing with me for antiquity sites now. Wow, tough scout. Dude just endured some cannon fire. I don't know if there's a lot of value in chasing him around, but I'm still enjoying it. Oh my god, China! Go away! I'm trying to get something done here. Keep breaking our suzerainty. Alright, I guess Mvemba can help, right? We can make an industrial zone, or an entertainment complex, somewhere near Mbanza Mpangu. Yeah, I guess right here, whatever, we'll just remove the woods. And hopefully be able to spread out some happiness in that direction. Man, we're not going to be able to finish anything. Here, make a monument. City's having housing problems, but I sort of don't care. It would be cool if they could build a commercial district, I guess. It would give us another trade route, at least. Here comes that satellite. I wonder if we'll get a little cinematic. Now, when we launch this, we gain a bunch of culture, right? Is that... am I remembering that right? We could definitely use some culture. Whew, the AI turns are taking longer and longer. Ah, here we go. Alright, and now I can see everything, right? So barbarian camps can
no longer
spawn.
Many of us take better care of our automobiles than we do of our own bodies. Yet the auto has replaceable parts.
To be fair, taking care of the automobile usually just involves, often just involves, replacing the parts. If I could replace my body parts, I would just do it, man. So it doesn't actually reveal everything. It gives me fog of war vision over everything. So no, sadly, bad guys can still spawn. Alright, what's next? Launch moon landing. This is the thing that gives you the culture bonus. One-time culture bonus equal to 10 times your science. Okay, so in 22 turns, we will suddenly get a huge amount of culture. Unfortunately, 22 turns is like a really long time. Yeah, let's start building stuff in Quila's amenity complex here, which is neat looking. To keep feeding amenities into Mbanza Kongo. We lost Geneva. Honestly, I don't know that that matters at this point. Hey, we're gonna tech out before we finish the stuff. How many turns are we away from the next part? Quite a few, actually. So where are we? What's the thing I'm currently researching? Combined arms. This is boosted, so 5, 7, 12, 18, 25 turns to the next thing. Let's see, how can we boost any of these? We could build an airstrip to help this out, but probably not in time, since it's the current bottleneck. Is there anywhere we could build an airstrip, like, quickly? Oh, we'd have to build an aerodrome first, right? Yeah, never mind. We won't be able to rush that out. You know what? Yeah, go ahead and make Broadway. Maybe we'll get lucky and get a boost to something we really need. Oh, we scored another apostle. He can't become a martyr, so he goes to sleep. I'm still not really clear on what the value of these apostles is to me. I know there's a wonder that makes it so whenever you get an apostle, they get the martyr ability for free and then also get one more thing. So maybe the idea is just that you try to get that and that way you can get a lot of relics out of your dudes, or maybe you just pray for the martyr ability to come up a lot. But like, since it's necessarily not my religion, spreading it is only detrimental to me in that it helps another player win the game. I don't know, it seems odd. I guess maybe the idea is that you're supposed to use it to help spread the religion to the rest of your cities? I suppose it could be. Alright. Yes, a barbarian is approaching. Alright, this guy is actually going to die soon. You need to go to... I guess just a place that has... Why don't we send him to a place that has a culture district and a science district, and we'll just see what we can do. Because your spying abilities seem to be based on the districts that are built at the target. So who's doing well on culture? Apparently I'm leading. China. I don't know that I want to antagonize China, though. Let's do St. Petersburg. Let's do a Russian city. I don't want to antagonize China anymore on account of the fact that they, are on my border and could actually attack me. So this is an ancient Aztec thingy. Alright, so you have ancient Aztec, ancient Chinese, and then we have a loose ancient something else, right? Ancient Geneva. There we go. Themed. That's in Quilla. So we want to actually, can I not move? I want to move this stuff to a different museum. I want to, we have a museum in the capital, and I need that one to have a theming bonus in it. So it doesn't, maybe I'm not doing it right, but there doesn't seem to be a way to, man, I really want, okay. Well, we're going to have to just find more stuff, I guess, and have things overflow into this. But I'm a little frustrated by the fact that there doesn't appear to be a way to move great works. Except when it would create a theming bonus. I guess make a something. Yeah, we'll make an amenity complex here. Entertainment complex. And try to just spread amenities all over the place. So the way the industrial complex buildings and the entertainment complex buildings work has really driven home the importance of creating a dense empire. You don't just want to have a lot of cities. You want to have a lot of cities on top of each other so that they can feed each other value through the production-creating buildings in the industrial complex. In fact, that's a really good way to make a new city good right away, is to have it be close to one of those things. Alright, here. Finally, scout dead. Fire. There we go. Clicking it the first time appears to just center the camera on it, which is kind of annoying. If I'm clicking on it, it's visible to me. That's all the centering that needs to be done. Alright, so we have some plus twos and a single plus three. Well, whatever gets us the most production. Spaceport's almost finished. So this spaceport's actually going to lie fallow for a little bit, and improving our science output would speed things up. Well, let's see what we can do. Oh yeah, I remember that. I'm sorry, what? We have 150 gold income and 2,000 sitting in the bank. You are extremely wrong. One of your spies has fed you some bad information or something. Alright, well, I guess, is there anywhere that we can buy science buildings or something?
Better to fight for something. When they are preparing for war, those who rule by force speak most copiously about peace. Until then.
Trigger Eureka moment with three random technologies. That's not really what we're looking for. Well, this is interesting. This district's regional buildings provide plus two production. That'll be nice in the capital. Alright, so what is an easy way to increase... you should move back toward the front somewhere, just so we're ready. What is an easy way to increase science? I mean, we could move a couple of cities onto science. We can buy research labs. Not labs. Lab, singular. And then we can do... I guess we're going to do some campus research grants. Your campus is all set. So we don't actually have any academies or seaports. We had a policy in here that gave amenities, didn't we? Well, I guess just reduce unit upkeep. Like, we don't... None of this stuff is any good. Yeah, unfortunately. There's just, like, there's no value from red policies for us. I don't think we're gonna go for police state. We don't seem to be getting spied on very much anyway. Although, I guess maybe I wouldn't know. I'm not really sure how it works. Peter has warned the Chinese leader about interfering with his agenda. So, we get a little bit of the insight into how the AI conduct diplomacy with each other. Interfering with his agenda. And remember, that agenda is that you should have more science and culture than he does. Interfering with that, it's kind of a strange way to put it. Here's a thing we can do to get more science. Oh, I can't buy that tile. There's a... Right. City-state owns it. Yeah, it looks like we're mostly just waiting. Okay, Great Lighthouse gets built in 1660. That sounds about right. Yeah, so many of these can only be boosted with great scientists or spies, and I'm assuming that the only way to boost it with a spy is to have a spy planted in the country of a person who already has it. Since we're the science leader, we're not going to be able to do that. So we just have to hope for the appropriate great scientists to come up, I guess. But like I said, we might get lucky with Tesla. How many turns are we from earning him? Or Schrodinger, rather. 30 points per turn, so we're looking at like 11 or 12 turns, depending on how things fluctuate. And I guess it'll be a little cheaper, because when these complete, we'll suddenly get some points, I think. There's a single English knight. Stealing the tech boost to rocketry. Now, the word stealing here doesn't actually mean stealing, right? It means copying. Yeah. He gained a tech boost to rocketry. I don't care about that. I'm not at all concerned about them starting rocketry.
If you miss, it has been demonstrated
100
that no
turns
system,
after we did.
Not even the most inhuman can continue to exist without an ideology.
Okay, so class struggle is going to hook us up. This is going to help a lot. Obviously, that's pretty great. Wow, no war weariness from combat in your territory. Does it mean no war weariness in our territory? Also, what is this? England, what are you doing? Maybe they're going to settle up here? That's right, I actually am okay with them settling around here somewhere. It makes them hate us less. I assume she's headed over here. I don't know where else she would put a city. I guess technically you can build a city in this space, but I don't know if that would be worth doing, really. We lost Kabul. I don't think that one's too important. Yeah. I wouldn't mind getting Geneva back. We have to gain 3 envoys with them. They do have a quest for us. What is the... No, they don't. Never mind. So yeah, we want to push up into the zoo, we just have to build the amenity, or the thing to get there. Okay. So, steel, military tactics. 1 tech boost, including the other one. Oh, we could steal a great work, that's pretty cool. Let's gain sources, because our chance of hitting on these is all, it's pretty low. So this will level our spy up, or cause our spy to act as though he is a higher level. Which has to be good. I don't know exactly what degree of difference it's going to make, but it has to be helpful. How's Mvemba Kongo doing? We're approaching housing cap. It wouldn't be the end of the world, though. We could probably put together an imbonza pretty quickly. Oh, sorry. Who needs orders? No, you're good. You don't actually need orders. So this is still Mbwila and Sangha. Oh, Sangha's hit the housing cap. Yeah, 89 turns. Jeez. Sorry. So there's a soft housing cap at 1 point under your housing capacity, and then there's a another one at exactly the housing capacity where your growth slows even more, and then at, I believe, 5 points above housing capacity, you stop growing entirely. So we have to try to keep our cities from hitting that, but honestly, we'll be fine. Yeah, you know what? Let's do research lab before we go building a zoo. 1720? Yeah, let's just build it. I was thinking maybe we could build the zoo and then buy the research lab out instead, but that only makes sense if you would get it done faster. Yeah. Just do something. Do anything. I do wish that when you mouse over the government on this thing, it would show you the card slots that it has. It's kind of silly that it doesn't. So, we're 2 turns off of that. That'll speed things up a little bit. Plus 1% for every 20 turns. I don't know how much longer the game is going to be, but it'll be, we'll get a couple of extra percent slowly. It does seem like the high-tier governments here are less powerful than the high-tier ideology things were in Civ 5. We better go deal with this camp. Oh, yeah, sure. Why not make him a mechanized infantry? So we're building up amenities. Did I put this is the complex here? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, it does reach to Mbanza Congo as long as we hold on to Toronto. Right, because I think it's naturally only, the zoo only affects 3 spaces by default. So what is your strength? 90. Well, we're definitely going to show this scout who's boss. And 3 movement. Alright, progress toward Cold War has advanced. We can build the Manhattan Project.
The class struggle necessarily leads to the dictatorship of the proletariat.
Alright, so let's move up to Communism. So it has one less wildcard slot, but one more yellow slot. And we were just using our wildcard slot for yellow stuff anyway. So what do we want most? Obviously, I think this is a winner. Campus and industrial zone adjacency bonuses are good. Receive 100 plus double gold yield from commercial hub buildings. That's not terrible, but I don't think that we can buy out almost any of the things that we're interested in finishing here. Still, it's the only one of these that's like really at all interesting. I guess plus 4 food is good. Yeah, we have a lot of domestic trade routes. Okay, yeah, I think that's sensible. And then, do we have any red policies that increase meaningful production or anything at all? No, none of this stuff does anything I care about. Well, let's throw in Patriotic War and I guess Defense of the Motherland. Let's check these green ones too. Have we gotten anything more valuable here? Not really. Okay. I'm fine with this government. Wow. That's fairly effective. Alright. I mean, just jam on the research, I think. So we've discovered some uranium in our land. Let's buy a builder. We may as well. Oh, I can't buy a builder because there's a civilian unit sitting here already. Oh, wait. I want this. Alright, so let's have a look at the remaining civics. Let's see what is most useful. Nuclear program would allow us to get more great scientist points. That's pretty good. What else is left? Cultural heritage, which awards envoys. Gives tourism-related stuff. Let's just find shipwrecks. That's cool. None of this stuff is relevant to what we're doing. Grants the ability to construct an additional spy is whatever. Ooh, that's a handy policy. That's not great for us, but it's definitely players for whom it would be great. Stadium is a pretty powerful building. That's pretty powerful. How about Space Race? Ah, okay, that's interesting. So let's make this the next focus. I do want to get nuclear program first. And then does any of the rest of this stuff... No, not really. Okay, Space Race is the last thing that is actually helpful to our victory. We're going to have to build a military academy in this city, which I think means we're going to have to build an encampment. I can't imagine that being very difficult, though. We have a ton of production. And other than that, we just need to jam on science and not get nuked or anything. I don't know how how difficult that's actually going to turn out to be. This is actually pretty interesting, too. Okay, so spaceport is complete. Not really anything interesting to do here yet. We're just kind of waiting for the next thing to unlock. Our campus is completed. Our industrial zone is completed. Commercial hub. More trade routes. That would help. All of the routes out of Mvemba, Kongo are used? Is that right? Weird. I guess you also go to Kongo? Oh, we lost... No, what happened is we lost 2 trade route capacity. Right, because the our form of government was giving us 2 trade route capacity. So actually... we need to build a couple of commercial hubs just to get back to the trade routes that we were at before. How unfortunate. And unfortunately, I think we really have we have commercial districts in a lot of our cities. Egypt has pillaged an enemy market with a privateer. This is really specific information that we do not need. Oh, I suppose we need to, if we actually want to get more works and try to theme up the museum here, we have to produce some more archaeologists, which means probably producing more museums. There's a lot of little things we can be doing to optimize here, and if I'd had a better plan from the beginning of the game, I could put them to sleep to get them to stop asking me, but I will forget to reactivate them when the commercial hub spawns. So let's just leave them in one more turn mode for now. That's just not efficient use of ammunition. They're all dead instantly, and he just kept shooting for several seconds. What do you think, bullets grow on trees, man? A knight and a battering ram. Alright. He really should speak. It's just... It looks so silly, the way he does that. He should just say something. Anything. Alright, so we have enemy settlers running around. This English settler has been running around through our territory for like a really long time. I have no idea why. Oh no, we lost Toronto. Damn it, China. Alright, well, we're gaining influence more quickly than we were before, and we're getting envoys slightly more effectively than we were before. Slightly more efficiently, I should say. Alright, come on, Schrodinger. Let's get some lucky boosts here. Fusion, stealth, composites. I think fusion was one we wanted. Yeah, that was one we needed. Nanotech is boosted, but we boosted this the old-fashioned way. Okay, we did need composites as well. So we got lucky on that. We got two good ones. Alright, you guys just keep holding on. Alright, so that probably cut like 6 to 10 turns off of our weight, right? How much behind are we? We need two more envoys to get these guys back. We're losing suzerain status everywhere, and we're not producing envoys quickly enough to make up for it. I wonder if the AI gets a boost to their influence generation. Because it seems like it's just China that's keeping two of them off of us. And China is definitely generating more envoys on those two city-states than we are generating in total.
The release of atom power has changed everything except our way of thinking. The solution to this problem lies in the heart of mankind. If only I had known, I should have become a watchmaker.
Okay, before we decide whether we're slotting that great scientist thing... Ooh, 350 science for every artifact in this city. That would be lovely to get. Yeah, let's go ahead and put the improved great scientist point thing in. So we'll pull... Oh no, not this. What will we pull for it? +1 amenity to our cities or +2 housing? Honestly, we're probably okay on housing. And we have more ways of dealing with housing than we do of dealing with amenities. Alright, so actually I want to rebase... I should have rebased these earlier. Why can't I... Oh, because I have selected the one in. Alright, And we will mine stuff, and we will build stuff, and... You know what? No, let's just keep hammering on the research thing. Alright, I definitely told too many of these guys to wait. One of them was supposed to go back out right away. You can see we're only at 5 of 6 running trade routes. You're good, man. Just stop asking me for orders. Take some initiative. You're promoted. You're a general now. Go figure out your own path. Looks like Mbanzo Mpangu's amenity problem has largely been fixed. Kwango needs housing, but like I said, that should be fairly easy to fix. I think we captured one of his spies. He'll give us ivory, which we don't have, and some money. Yeah, sure. You can have your spy back. I'm okay with that. They should probably let you actually see this before offering the deal to get them back. Sabotage production! Yeah, that would have been real bad. Maybe we shouldn't have given him his spy back. Can I assign my spies to counter-spying? I bet I can. Okay, so we could have more guys. And apparently we were like really close on housing in a bunch of places, and removing that social policy has screwed up everything. That's fine. We'll fix this. So, can we purchase anything that gives housing. No, because everything is incredibly expensive. Well, the city obviously is pretty busy. You go get this source of uranium now. You know, this is still a pretty bad chance for success. Would I rather just have him steal some gold? Yeah, let's do that. Gain the gold yields of St. Petersburg during the mission's duration. So for 8 turns, we steal all their gold? Really? Well, that's very interesting. this city could use more housing, I suppose, and it doesn't take very long to build Mvemba. I do want to have people work on research, but I also want the cities to be growing. So we have 8 turns until moon landing. And how many turns with after boosts? We have 4 more turns until nuclear fusion. We can start working on the Mars reactor. And here's the hydroponics, and oh wait, could Kongo? I thought I... Yeah, we don't actually have access to build the
big laser believer.
Mars really habitation thing. Hold on. Hold on. Business. A great writer. Sure. So, for the science victory... Yeah, we have robotics researched already. Can we not start building Mars habitation until we do the moon landing, maybe? Oh, you know what? That might be what it is. That's why they're laid out like this, because you need completed progress in one to move on to the next. Okay. So as soon as we finish this, we'll be able to start building Mars habitation in one place and the reactor in the other. Okay. Yeah, you still don't have a job. Sorry. I suppose it makes sense to put things in the capital. Although I don't think it really matters for these works of writing, right? This amphitheater is themed. Cool.
A bird came down the walk. He did not.
Oh, we can put stuff in the in Oxford too. That's right. Does Oxford theme? Doesn't look like it. I'm assuming this isn't supposed to say themes, since none of the other amphitheaters suggest that there's an ability to theme. It's a weird bug. Out of curiosity, how are we doing on a culture victory? We have 35 tourists, which is not even close to the amount that we would need to have. Jeez. I have read on the subreddit people talking about having accidentally won a culture victory while they were on the way to a science victory.
Success is counted sweetest by those who...
But it seems like you would have to either have very poor science and production or extremely good culture output for that to be the case, given the values we're seeing here. Alright, so let's make a spy so that we can counter-spy in the capital. Plus 1 industry cannot be the best thing. Yeah, there's plus 2 there, plus 3 here. Go. Alright, this guy's going to sleep because I don't have any idea when we're next going to have a commercial district open up. You know, when we hit this, we're going to finish all of the policies that we care about, and then I have no idea what we're going to do from there. Unfortunately, like I said, we can't really buy anything of value with all this gold, as far as I can tell. We kind of have all the buildings that we need to have. Huh, that's interesting. If the suzerain of the city-state has a different government than you, your envoys are doubled. That's... There's some interesting maneuvering you can do there. Hey, Sean Bean was talking. I was going to interrupt him. Man, why are they so expensive? It does seem like a little much, doesn't it? Can you become a martyr?
No.
Then go forth and rest for all of eternity. Which sounds a lot more sinister than I mean it to. Operation Ivy allows for the creation of thermonuclear devices. And I don't think I want that. Let's finish making spies. We should probably have the maximum number of spies. You have a commercial hub. I guess make a museum? I don't know, man. Oh no, actually, you need housing. Alright, well, not much to do but wait, unfortunately. The science victory does seem to be a little tedious. Yep, and the AI likes to denounce you a lot, but it doesn't like to do anything after denouncing you. They insist that you are weak because it's been a lot of games now, right, in this series. There have been a lot of Civilization games. And somehow, they've never figured out a way to make the AI recognize what your military strength is. The AI has been making bad decisions in my general direction for a long time, based on the fact that they just cannot reckon what a military looks like. It doesn't seem all that complicated, frankly. Especially with this system where the Baltic
to Trieste in the Adriatic.
Do we actually want any of these?
Curtain has descended across the continent.
This isn't bad. Do I want to maybe pull charismatic leader for weakening enemy spies? Yeah, I think this is probably going to have a greater effect. But what I was saying is with the system they have set up in this game for combat strength with the way the relative differences work, it seems like it would be really easy to map out somebody's combat strength, military strength relative to yours by recognizing that units you have that are tremendously weaker than their units are not actually valuable. Right? It's not that every player has a raw military score. It's that every player has a military value in relation to each other player. Because you have to consider the strength of their units relative to the strength of yours. I don't know, that doesn't seem like that complicated of a system, really. I wonder why they haven't done something like that. Because, like, Cleopatra should be able to tell that I'm not weak, that my military could... Like, we could go over there and just roll all over her country at any time, and there's literally nothing she could do to stop us. A great musician. Okay. I don't think we have any music slots, but we have those slots in the palace that can hold anything, so I guess we'll just use this. Oh no, never mind, we have all kinds of stuff here. The broadcast center. Yeah, sure, go put your other great work in the broadcast center, I guess. Save the slots of the capital for things that can only be built in the capital. And look at that, China's got an anti-tank crew. Anti-tank crews are a little out of date at this point. Mechanized infantry are a good 20 points stronger. But they're not that far behind. Oh, and they stole my wonder! China's actually catching up, on science at least. Or, wait, did we get Broadway from the civics tree? I think we probably did. I do like Tchaikovsky, but we're busy right now, man. Okay. Lots and lots of free apostles that I have no use for at all. All This city should definitely keep building amenity stuff because they feed the capital. This city can pretty much just make science. At this point, I was going to build a museum into a... What do you call it? A museum into an archaeologist and try to get stuff for the capital's museum, but... Honestly, that might be so slow as to be irrelevant at this point. Alright, so is that satellite just about to launch? Yes, it is. And perfect, Quango's just finishing a thing. So we can start working on two pieces of the space race in tandem. Right as we get the integrated space cell, which not only is good for us, but is a red policy. We don't have military academies in either of these cities. Well, let's see how long it would take to build them. It does seem like in Space Race might contribute a little bit more than it's contributing here. Alright, so great big fat culture bonus.
In the hierarchy of the major poetic substances, we choose to go to the moon in this decade and do...
Alright. I'm not 100% sure that this is actually valuable to us, but... There's no good reason for us not to put it in here. And now let's try to suss out the relative costs of our various plans. So 4 turns of encampment, and then we buy out the other things we need, right? Would give me a 15% boost on this, which would cut it... we go from about 100 to about 115. Yeah, I mean, that's significant. These seem like huge, huge numbers. Way larger than they need to be. Alright, let's go for it. Yeah, just build an encampment, I don't know, over here. And Mbonza Kongo needs to do the same thing. And Mbonza Kongo actually doesn't have the population for that. Let's make an Mbonza. So at this point, there's nothing left in the civics tree that actually helps us. Right? Plus 5 production from international trade routes. Never mind, that's actually helpful. Okay, apparently it's only going to take us 2 turns. Oh right, because we have the huge boost, the overflow from launching the satellite. You need to go to Mbonza Kongo, actually. I assume my cities are going to be at the top of the list. Yeah, go here. And protect the industrial zone. Oh, that's interesting. They can protect the zone, a district, and all of its adjacent districts. Yet more reason to be very careful how you build your cities. There must be something else this guy can do that's valuable. Where do we have a thing unimproved? Is there anything around the capital? Wow, there's a stone that doesn't have a quarry on it in the capital. That's crazy. Actually, you know what? We've been not focusing on industry in this city. The capital's focused, but Quango isn't. I think this will probably not actually take effect until the beginning of the next turn. I would expect with us choosing to focus that the number would actually go up, right? Somebody built Big Ben. Yeah, people are not that far behind us on tech anymore. We've been doing a lot of big, slow techs. They've probably just been tearing up the tree.
A good plan violently executed right now is far better than a perfect plan executed next week.
Okay, so globalization's actually going to take several turns. Alright, we stole some gold. Oh, money's available for a promotion. Oh, interesting. Let's have him focus on siphon funds. So he is now level 2, effectively, and he siphons funds as if he were level 4. I imagine that makes him pretty effective. And we got some money, but I don't really know what I want to do with it. so lots of science from this guy. That's nice. Ooh, look at that. 1500 production toward a space race. And we are just about to get him. The things we have left to build are 3,000 production each, so that's actually really big. He's gonna cut these in half. Sleep. You need to siphon funds, shockingly. I guess this guy goes to Kongo. I'm pretty sure we just moved a spy out of Kongo, so maybe that's a little... maybe we didn't do this in the most effective order. I'm willing to concede that that's a possibility. Alright, I think we need to focus on campus research grants. How many turns are we looking at until we have our last piece available? 2, 3, 8. Okay, never mind. Never mind, we are not actually hurting for science anymore. I guess just get started on something. It should take him about as long to do that as it takes this city to do the other two combined, including the bonus from that great merchant, or that great engineer, rather. Yeah, so see, this is what I was talking about. China's producing envoys more quickly in both Geneva and Toronto than I'm producing envoys in total, I think. Alright, well, let's go to 10. Become suzerain here. I think that it's pretty important. It certainly helps us move production around. And hold the other one, I guess? So when we get to 200 points, at 7 points per turn, it's going to be a win. It should be very, very close to us launching the last piece, actually, before we get more envoys. Honestly, I cannot believe how long this is taking. Like, we basically won a science victory, like, at the beginning of the last video, in the sense that, oh, you want diplomacy? Our capital is not accepting new residents at this time. Go away. You're trying to do some sneaky spy shit. I know you. You can't fool me. Yeah, like, we were in position and basically unassailable. I guess China could build a bunch of anti-tank crews and declare war on us. These crouching tigers aren't going to do anything. The difference in the combat strength of our cities with the combat strength of his units is going to make our cities basically unassailable even though they don't have walls. So let's see. Where's the highest value? Mvemba is at 5 industry now. Bonzo Kongo needs, what is it, a military academy, which requires an armory, which requires either a barracks or a stable. Okay, so let us buy those things. Barracks, I guess, and then an armory, and then a military academy. Alright, and then... down to 23 turns. So it was 31 before. We spent 4 turns to take 8 turns off of that. I think that's perfectly reasonable. Counter-spy. Can I just press that? Protect the industrial zone. So I guess I could have multiple counter-spies in the capital, right? One of them in the industrial zone and the other one in the rocketry space? Maybe? Yeah, I guess we're not capped on spies. Let's make that happen. And the rest of the cities in the Empire have become a little bit irrelevant. It's just a matter of waiting. When globalization hits, we'll slot e-commerce and then turn a lot of our trade routes outward. I'm assuming +5 production from international trade routes does apply to trade routes with city-states. And if that's true, then we have a couple of city-states that are going to go up to, like, +8 or +9. I guess some of China's cities have decent output already as well. So How far off are we on this guy? Okay, so we're gonna get him right now. The units are stacked up all over the thing, okay. So it's on 8 points, or it's on 8 turns now. So this being the case, do I want to turn my trade routes outward now? Is their value set when we put them out? Or does it update dynamically? I have no idea. I'm going to send a trade route to Quila, I guess. I'll assume that it sets the value of the trade route when you send it. It's a shame that we're going to get globalization right after we start a bunch of trade routes. Oh, that's pretty cool too. I like, there's a number of things in the trees that are for helping you catch up in the other tree if you happen to get way ahead on one. And I really do like that. Obviously, you're not going to perform a globalization rush or anything, but I do think it lends itself to some interesting strategies. I'm a little surprised that nobody has ever bothered to declare war on us, but I'm not going to complain about it. So the Mars reactor is going to get done right before, or right after we get the tech for the next thing, I think. All right, yeah, sure. Paintings. We could do with some paintings, I guess. So the military buildings do just give raw production. I wonder if they affect the production output of the city. Counter-spy. The industrial zone is over here, so this is also protecting the campus. It is not protecting the spaceport. Yeah, sure. Just make great works. Make stuff happen. Alright, I'm going to send this to the capital as well. And have him, I guess, protect the spaceport. I don't know what spying on the spaceport would do. I assume it removes industry from the project or raises the cost of the project or something. That would be a thing that I would not like to happen. A lot of blue dudes in my territory. Sort of blue, like a teal and red. Is that teal? I don't know colors, man. Sort of like a light sort of greeny blue. It's bleeding into sea foam a little bit, maybe. I feel like we had and dismissed the Hermitage message already, didn't we? Oh, and he built Cristo Redentor as well. Is he going to try to get a culture victory?
It is obvious that while science is struggling to bring heaven job. To Earth, some men are using its materials in the construction of hell.
Alright, so 3 turns until the mine, or until the nanotechnology is available. And we're continuing to basically just wait. Yeah, sure, make a zoo. Why not? And why don't you do something that takes a long time so that you can stop asking me for orders? Yeah, build Operation Ivy. Let's get ready to nuke somebody. I don't think we have anywhere to put another painting, do we? No, it looks like... Oh, we have some writing here. We can move this to a writing slot. And then he can make his next painting here. Yeah, so I guess when you get your theater squares going, you do seem to acquire great works at a pretty impressive rate. If we really focused on culture from the beginning of the game, I wonder how hard it would be to win a culture victory earlier than somebody could win a science victory. Nope, still no. I really don't have a good handle on all the tourism sources. Obviously, great works generate tourism, but we were getting a lot of tourism from something before we ever produced any great works. I think wonders... give tourism now, but I really wish that this was more helpful. Like, plus 282 from cities is not a meaningful readout.
One day there will be no borders, no boundaries, no flag.
Alright, let's figure something out here. So, plus 4 food from domestic trade routes can probably go in favor of plus 5 production and plus 10 gold from international routes. And is Van Gogh actually still producing stuff? Does he just get to produce a lot more than people normally do? Alright, this is a work of music, but we don't have another broadcast center. This time we actually are out of place. Or out of places to put his thing. I guess just go to sleep, man. Like, we don't have anything useful for you to do, sorry. Hey you, build a theater square. Build a place for this guy to put his paintings. Alright, now I think we actually are out. We can just do globalization again? No, apparently not. It says it can be completed multiple times. Maybe that's only true if you also have social media done? I guess, could be. That could be what's happening. Alright, so I think 29 turns is going to be about the time that the Mars Hydroponics finishes. Plus 3 amenities for the city, plus 4 housing for the city. That's really cool. It grants 2 genes. Oh, it's Levi Strauss. That's kind of funny. Abdus Salam. It triggers the Eureka moment for all technologies from the information era. He's like a late-game great library. Oh, hey, sculptures! Okay, so some artists create sculpture instead of paintings. That makes sense. So right here, we want you to counter-spy, protect the spaceport. I don't know what necessarily anybody's going to do, but let's just be paranoid. Being paranoid is better than being screwed. I know that we're past an hour already, but I kind of don't want to do another episode that's just, hey, let's stare at the spaceport bars filling up, so let's just run this thing all the way to its conclusion, shall we? A recent news article revealed that Egypt is trading with Aztec. I think it's interesting that it's no longer the Aztecs or the Aztec Empire, it's now just Aztec. I wonder if that's rooted in the way that people from that region would describe it.
Many, many rules had begun to bend at the hand of...
Alright, so we are killing it, but very slowly. So we can start researching future tech. We just, like, nothing else does anything, right? We can get more units, but we don't need them. Oh, whatever. Future tech. So yeah, it takes way too long to build these. You should not be able to finish the tech tree and then have another 25 turns to go before you finish building stuff. And it might just be that my cities are so poorly constructed that they're making it take forever and that it goes much more quickly if you've been more thoughtful in your constructions, that you have more access to industry. But I feel like we actually ended up in a pretty good place as far as industry goes. Maybe I'm wrong about that. But, like, this is taking forever, man. We maybe won't go for a science victory again. Alright. My agent stole a bunch of gold. I don't even know what to do here. Sure. Learn how to disrupt rocketry. You can, I guess, go to Kwanko? We can have a spy in this spaceport as well. Seems fine. Yeah, Monza, why not? Most of our cities just have so little to contribute at this point. Yeah, you know what? Harvest the stone. Jam all that stone in the reactor. Let's get this thing going. I suppose that's something I could be doing. I could be running around harvesting resources. So that harvest gave us 232 production? That actually seems like really a lot. Maybe this is actually a good plan. Hold on a second. Let's buy some builders. I'm gonna buy one in Kongo as well. Alright, let's just start consuming all of the stuff around these two cities. Unfortunately, there's not a lot of things sort of out in the open anymore. If I have one of the builders, I wonder if we can harvest this copper in the same way. And if we did, which city it would go to. Because we don't get to choose, right? It probably just goes to whatever's closest. These two cities are... Oh no, Kongo is slightly closer to this than Mvemba is. Okay, so yeah, we'll just start pulling stuff up, jamming it into the spaceships. They're going to be an unholy amalgamation of raw metals and stone and stuff.
Keep score?
Let's see here. So we got a couple of plus sevens. Plus five, plus five, plus seven. Plus eight. There we go. More industry. Were you already counter-spying? I think that spy was already... I guess the counter-spy mission must have ended. Can we harvest the uranium? What are you doing? We have like a wall of apostles. Get back over here. Yeah. Siphon his funds. I don't know. Steal his tech boost. Do whatever. I don't care. Alright, so 24 turns. Kongo is definitely going to be the bottleneck here. We don't have any great people coming along that are going to be relevant, unfortunately. Somebody got Levi Strauss, and we're going to get cosmetics instead, which are basically the same, but with a different name. But how will we make all the other civilizations listen to our rock music and buy our blue jeans if we don't have any blue jeans? It's an intractable problem. I guess we're going to have to go to Mars. It's the only way out. No more apostles, please. Go stand somewhere out of the way. Stadium, sure. I'm doing everything in my power to make this not be end turn 23 times. I hope you understand. I'm trying, guys. I really am. These builders are about to get to where they're going. Hopefully we can just mulch up a bunch of stuff and get this from 23 turns down to something more like, I don't know, 10 maybe? After we carve everything up. There's a forest here that isn't chopped yet. There's a forest here that isn't chopped yet. I don't know if we can actually do the harvest thing on a resource that we already built an improvement on. It may be that it doesn't work that way. Yeah, just counter-spy, man. I'm pretty sure that you guys have jobs already. Why don't you just stick to them? If we need you, we'll call you. Alright, so the apostles, I'm still pretty annoyed about the fact that there's nothing to do with them. You can't just sell them or anything. Because I get that if you can sell units... No, honestly, it's not a problem. If you could sell units that you can buy with faith, it would give you a way of turning your faith directly into gold, which can then be used to buy things that are not faith units. So I suppose that's the problem they were going for, is that they don't want you to use faith to buy non-faith things. But at least give us a delete button then. What is this? He wants uranium in exchange for some citrus. Sure, man. Go ahead, make some nukes. See if I care. It'll take him so long to make the nukes. We'll be on Mars by the time they get here. Huh. Yeah, I can see a lot. There's a lot of late game tourism boosters. It was like that in Civ 5 too. You could work all game on your tourism stuff, and from turn 1 till turn 95% of the way through the game, you'd produce less than half of the tourism output that you would produce in the last couple of turns. So I can remove this rainforest for 92 production. That's something. I cannot bulldoze this. I cannot remove this luxury resource. I do not know how to harvest copper. Alright, get the trees, I guess? We have a lot of cities, man. A lot of cities that constantly need orders and reassurance. So we got one turn off of it. That was something. Oh, you know what? I never actually did this. There's so many things that you should be able to do while it's not actively your turn. I try not to be like, hey, Endless Legend does it this way, maybe you should do it this way. But there are so many things you can do in Endless Legend while it's not your turn. I was playing multiplayer earlier today, and when you hit end turn in Civ, you can't do anything until the next turn starts or until you uncheck ready. But I should be able to do trivial stuff like rename units, right? You can't, if you have a unit that has a naming available because it got to level 2, or because it got to level 3 rather, you can't name it while you're in the ready-to-go state. You can't add technologies to the end of your technology queue with shift-clicking, which is obviously something you should be able to do. It's very silly how it locks you out of UI completely.
To create the future.
More future tech. Go, go. So I assume I'm not going to be able to harvest this then. 189. Are there any more? Yeah, there's a forest here. We're going to have to move this apostle. Because surprise, surprise, the apostles are in the way. And, like, I can't issue a movement order for him to follow next turn as though I had issued it, you know, on the previous turn before hitting next turn. Which is just silly. Of course I should be able to do that. Where are these guys going? I guess they're going to try to convert people on the other continent. Sounds like a tall order to me. I'm going to be honest with you, if I were playing this game alone, not on the channel, I would have quit 50 turns ago and gone, okay, I won that game. Chalk that up as a win in my head. So I can remove the improvement and then maybe harvest it? I don't know if you can do that with uranium. Probably not, right? Yeah, let's just go to this forest. Alright, let's move stuff out of the way and then go to this forest. Back to sleep. I wish that there was an easier way to know what is harvestable and what isn't. It's one of those things we're just gonna have to learn. Here's a forest. These apostles are everywhere, man. I guess we don't really need to focus on the capital. The capital is not the holdup. When trade routes complete, we'll start moving them to Kongo and shipping more industry into Kongo. Everybody's shouting at each other, there's wars constantly starting and stopping and starting and stopping, and we're just outside of all of it, slowly floating upward into space. That's how space travel works, right? You float upward slowly. Somewhere, the game is animating each movement of each unit sequentially. Just making the turns take forever. Whatever, man. Just do something that takes a long time and doesn't require me to talk to you again. I suppose it's not actually impossible for the AI to affect me here, but it's pretty close. I wish that when you harvested a thing, your builder had to actually pick it up and take it to the city that you want to use it in. Because first of all, that would allow you to, like, in a situation like this, turn this stone into production for this. And secondly, it would solve a little bit of the problem that they have in the early game, where your builders can just chop anything anywhere and have it count as production for the capital. Nope, sorry. Because I don't know if you guys have tried that yourself, but you can actually just send a builder out sort of as a scouting unit and just chop every forest you encounter and build stuff in your capital really quickly in the early game. It's not maybe a viable strategy overall. It's probably better to have a military unit scouting because it can continue to scout afterward. But it is a thing you can do, and it's very silly. Is there anything else that's worth pulling up? Can I kill this improvement and then harvest this? I probably can. That probably works. Alright, so it's gonna be a couple of turns yet. Is anybody close to any of the other victories? No. The Aztec look like they're about the same place on religion that they have been. Ooh, no, they have four techs. They have four people converted. They converted Pedro. So they have broken, they've got a foothold now on the other continent. And England doesn't have anybody's capital except for Norway's. So she would have to conquer an awful lot of cities in a real hurry to win the game that way. Oh hey, somebody's actually friendly to us. Maybe we'll take him to space. Oh. Well, I guess that's the end of that friendship. Our spy got caught. How is your agent going to try and escape? Oh, this is kind of cool. Pursued by police with no loot in hand. Police are more likely to be patrolling quick exits, such as the aerodrome or harbor. Exit by foot is always the safest option. Yeah, okay. Leave by foot. We don't really need that guy any faster. Yeah, counter-spy. It does seem like you should be able to just leave them in counter-spy mode and then come get them if you want them to do something else, doesn't it? Yeah, pull up the improvement. I want to see if we can do this. Okay, that did not spend its charge. That's good to know. That's the kind of thing we might need to do in a game at some point. So I'm pulling up the one that's not adjacent to the industrial zone first to see how effective this actually is. Look at the settler in his little RV. That's pretty cool. I love the detail on it. It's got the little steps coming up to the door and everything.
Even though the future seems far away.
You know, the future doesn't seem that far away. It kinda feels like it's behind us now, honestly. 236. Okay. Yeah, that helped. And you get to... There we go. So I noticed that Harvest was not in that menu to the left anymore. It was only above the unit portrait, which makes me wonder... yeah, just build something that's going to take a long time. Don't makes me wonder if I actually did have the option of harvesting the uranium and I just wasn't looking in the right location. What is the longest here? Build some modern armor. Everybody just build something that... Everybody go away, basically. I'm tired of giving you all orders. Alright, so we're about to have social media, and then we'll see what the status is of researching the end of the civics tree for extra score. Aztec has denounced the evil deeds of England. You know, everybody down here is so petty. I'm glad we're leaving. And whatever causes him to say this, the condition it's checking for is totally broken. Because we are, like, mega rich right now. Peter has warned Montezuma about interfering with the agenda money grubber. Yeah, so we're tripping his money grubber agenda. But I don't know. I mean, the only thing I could think of is that it causes him to not like you if you have less money than he does, and he has just a crazy amount
Which
of gold
of all
built
my
up.
Important nothing shall I tell you for?
Because there's literally no other situation that leads to him saying that we're poor, I think. Huh. Cannot be completed multiple times. Strange. I don't know. Do this. You guys really need to just keep counter-spying somewhere. I don't care where. Yeah, a lot of our units are asking for orders a lot more frequently than I would like. Let's rebase this. We might be able to get a turn off of Quango's build, maybe. I think that's the best we could hope for at this point. We'd have to be very close to a breakpoint for that to happen, but I haven't done the math. We might be close to a breakpoint. Yeah. He just, like, he opens his mouth like he's gonna roar at you and throws his arms down like he's having a temper tantrum and then just kind of wobbles in place a little bit. It's not the most intimidating thing I've ever seen. He looks like a drunk lion. A little bit like a drunk lion, I think. Man. Look at the city combat strength of China's cities compared to ours. It's crazy. Alright, there's a plus 8 right here. Yeah, we see a couple of plus 8s. I think plus 8's probably a winner. Alright, who gives us plus 8? You. I don't care anything else about the route. Just give me that plus 8. Build the Eiffel Tower. Just do something. We'll leave a significant portion of an Eiffel Tower here for anyone who would wish to complete it after we're gone. So yeah, we're at plus 7 amenities. We've got our housing capacity up to 23 and could easily have gotten it higher if I had bothered. Once you get into the late game, housing just becomes kind of a non-issue. I guess it's different for other people, right? We have a number of tiles in our area that have low appeal, like 0, 2, 1. And neighborhoods on these wouldn't actually give that much extra housing. It's just the Mbanza that makes housing completely trivial. But we're almost there. It is taking him so long to get where he's going. Oh my god, just go to sleep. Sure, sewer. Yep, this space is finally starting to get settled. It took a long time. Nobody has settled on Oil Trash Island. So I think next game, our plan is going to be to play a game that's kind of the opposite of this. We played here very peacefully, very defensively, very internally, and went for a science victory. Next game, I want to be much more interactive with the other players, which probably means some amount of war. And I want to try to go for a culture victory, because I do not really understand the sources of tourism that lead to a tourism victory, and I want to. Oh, almost there. If anyone was ever going to stop us, this is the time. I don't know, man. Make a broadcast center. Anything that takes longer than this component does. Alright, I don't think that we're even going to have the opportunity to harvest this. Right, because it's going to take one turn to remove the improvement. Yeah, I guess we'll, when this has one turn left, we'll be able to see if we could have harvested the uranium. I don't know why the harvest button didn't appear in his action area on the stone. I guess we just had too many different kinds of actions available to us at that point. Man. I think another part of the problem with the victory conditions, not just in Civ, but in these games, I don't suppose it's hidden in here, though. Is that the AI is just not capable of recognizing when things are irrelevant. The AI will continue to do things that just cannot possibly matter. Egypt has switched to democracy. Good for them. I hope they enjoy their democracy. See, yeah, we didn't play with naturalism. We didn't play with seaside resorts. Those are a thing. There's all kinds of cool stuff related to the tourism system that we just didn't get involved with at all. Alright, all of the tiny AI units moving around for no reason. The position of a warrior is no longer relevant. Maybe there's some kind of thing that could be implemented that just
forest for economic gain.
Just sort of removes units from the game when they can't matter anymore, like that. Okay, so no, we don't have the option. We don't need to do that. Just go to sleep. And here we go. Let's see what a science victory ending looks like. As soon as everybody's done moving over slightly, because they weren't quite happy with their position. So very slowly. Hey, Russia, build a spaceport. Good for them. Maybe we can make some interplanetary trade routes with them. This seems much longer than the wait between the other turns, right? Are we being punished? There we go. Right.
Much as our ancestors did ages ago, we thrust forward into the unknown. The first pioneers set forth on an uneasy course. And yet once again did our people thrive. Now, under your leadership, we plot a new course and make another world.
Okay, that was neat. I don't know why it was so much quieter than all of the other sound in the game has been, but that was pretty cool. So can we watch the... Is there not a map anymore? It's a series of graphs, but there's no Civ 5-style ending map. I really like that feature. Oh well, that's going to be the end of this episode and this game of Let's Play Civilization 6. Come back next time. I'm not 100% sure what we're going to do. But it's going to be more aggressive, it's going to be culture-based, and it's probably going to be on a higher difficulty, because that was a little bit on the easy side. And we'll see you then.